Good morning, and welcome to Breakfast with the Bucs. Today is Friday, December 2nd, and it is the day 3. It is a very special day here at W Buck. Today is Parent and Grandparent Turnaround Day. The on-air talent at W Buck is being joined by their parents or grandparents. My name is Kaylee Fitzsimmons, and I'm here with my mom.
Good morning. There will be an environmental club meeting today in room 102. Tomorrow night is the winter semi-formal. It will be held at the Elks Lodge, and the cost is $5 to get in. Students will need their IDs to enter. If you have any hats or mittens that you would like to donate, please drop them off in the sixth period box outside of room 153 or give them to Josh Cooley or Elijah Singleton. The donations will be given to the Salvation Army. Do you have any old coats laying around the house? Bring them in to support the coat drive sponsored by the Interact Club. There will be a drop-off box outside of Mr. Shaw's room. Now over to Mr. Dunsmore for the weather.
Thanks, Mrs. Fitzsimmons. My dad, John, is going to do the weather for you today.
The cause for concern today is the combination of wet roads and colder air arriving this afternoon. Roads and bridges will most likely become slick. A nice weekend is expected, though. Sunshine will be plentiful Saturday, with clouds gaining the upper hand Sunday. Now for the three-day forecast. Today we have a 30% chance of snow. We have a high of 44 and a low of 29. The weekend looks pretty clear with seasonable temperatures. Tomorrow we have a high of 46 and a low of 23. Sunday we're looking at a high of 51 and a low of 30. That's all for the weather now. Now over to Evan's mom, Mrs. Davis.
Thanks, Mr. Dunsmore. I'm Evan Davis and this is my mom here with your news.
Do you want to make a difference in the life of an American service member? Help support our military service men and women, veterans, and their families this holiday season by sending them a card through Holiday Mail for Heroes. All you have to do is send in a card with a brief message of encouragement and gratitude, then drop it in the box located at the front desk in the library. No postage or envelope is needed. The cards will be collected on December 9th. Please refrain from cards with glitter as it may interfere with medical equipment and instruments. For more information, contact Jake Getman. That's all for your news. Now over to Kevin's dad, Mr. Goodale.
Thanks, Ms. Davis. I'm here with my father, Harold, and he's going to be doing the sports for you guys.
With the loss of several significant players to graduation from last season's state Final Four squad, the Oswego Varsity Girls Hockey Team enters a rebuilding campaign in the 2011-2012 season. 2 years ago, we won a state championship. We lost a couple of significant players from that team, but last year we were still one of the favorites based on what we had returning, according to Coach Dan Bartlett. Oswego posted a 10-8 overall record in 2010-2011 and advanced to the state Final Four, falling to 5-1 in the state semifinals and losing the consolation game 4-0 to Potsdam. Two key returnees will be co-captains senior Sarah Gosick and junior Sarah Mancuso.
That's all for your sports. Now let's take it over to Kat's grandma with a joke of the day.
Oh, I didn't see you there. Well, today has been a really special show, but it's even better since my grandma, Gigi, is here with us in our studio. Gigi, do you have something to ask me?
Well, I want to say thank you very much for inviting me. It's a pleasure. It's very exciting. Now I've got a joke for you.
You do.
Jumper Cable walked into a bar, asked the bartender for a drink. Bartender says, okay, as long as you don't start anything. Get it?
Because he's a Jumper Cable.
Yeah. Get it? And telling that joke makes me want to start a bottle of wine.
Wow, Gigi, you're better at this than I am.
Oh, I don't think so, Cap. You're priceless.
Well, thanks for coming in today.
You're very welcome.
That's your joke and your show. Have a great day.